Hi everyone, Professor Tan here. This video will help you get started using Stata, which is a program widely used to perform statistical analysis of data. We'll cover the basics here with more in-depth applications during class. As you can see on my screen, I'm using Stata 14.1 on the Mac Mini in my office. The Windows version of Stata looks pretty similar, and all of the commands and directions should be the same. As always, feel free to let me know if you have any issues with Stata on your computer. We start off with a basic overview of the four windows in Stata. First, we've got the results window that will be our main display. Second, we have the command window on the bottom where we enter the Stata code. Next, we've got a review window on the left that will show a history of Stata commands that we've used. Finally, we have a variables window on the right that lists all of the variables in the data set. Right now, everything is basically empty because we haven't done anything yet, so let's get started. The first thing we'll need to do is to begin logging our commands, which will save a history of our progress. We can begin our log by clicking on the log icon on the toolbar, and then click on begin, and then we need to save our log. I'll call it MLB Salaries 2015. Notice that Stata saves log files in a .smcl format. Let's click on save to start the log. I'll be creating log files in our lab sessions during the semester, so it'll be important for you to also learn how to open these log files. More on that at the end of this video. Now that we've got our log file set up, let's open a Stata data file, which has the extension .dta. For this tutorial, we're going to use a dataset on player salaries in Major League Baseball that I've saved on my desktop. The easiest way to do this is to click on the open icon on the toolbar. Notice that Stata immediately searches for my files on my desktop. Depending on where you save the dataset, you might have to navigate to the appropriate folder. I'm going to select the file that I'd like to open and click the Open button. Stata can also import Excel spreadsheets, which is the most common file format in the real world. It's also the format of the datasets we'll be using in EC420. First, let's clear Stata's memory of the dataset we just opened by typing clear in the command window and pressing enter. Unfortunately, the open icon only works for .dta files, so in order to import an Excel spreadsheet, we start by clicking on File, then hover over Import, and click Excel Spreadsheet. Let's click on Browse, and select the Excel spreadsheet that we want to open, and click Open. Let's check the box for Import First Row as Variable Names, but let's leave the box for Import All Data as Strings unchecked. We can finally import the dataset by clicking OK. You can see that a history of the code that I've been using shows up in the review window. Also, now that I have the Excel spreadsheet open, you can see that the variables window shows a list of the variables in the dataset. Typing the describe command displays the contents of the dataset. For example, typing describe and then pressing enter gives us the following output. With Stata, a lot of commands have shortcuts. Instead of typing out describe, we can simply type out DES and press enter. Notice that we get the same output in the results window. The table tells us that we have 105 observations for 17 variables, including the player's first name, last name, number of at-bats, the number of hits, the number of home runs, whether the contract is a rookie contract, and the numerical value of the player's salary. Don't worry about storage type or display format for this course. The baseball fans in this class might be wondering why there are only 105 players in the dataset. I obtained data for non-pitchers with at least 500 at-bats in 2015. These are the players who would be eligible for the batting title that season. More on this in class. Now that we have the dataset opened in Stata, let's go ahead and check out the contents of the dataset. We can do this by clicking on the data browser icon or the data editor icon. Here's an important tip. If we were to click on the data editor icon, we would actually be able to manipulate the observations by changing the values for the different variables. We don't want to do that. So we use the data browser icon so that the data is in a read-only format. The observations in this data set are sorted by the number of home runs, where the player with the most home runs in the 2015 season is listed first. That year, Chris Davis of the Baltimore Orioles hit 47 home runs to lead the major leagues. We can scroll down and see the rest of the observations in the data set. Notice that this data browser ends at the 105th observation, since there are only 105 observations in the data set. Let's close this data browser and get back to the main Stata window. Stata can quickly calculate summer statistics by typing in summarize in the command window. The shortcut for summarize is simply SUM. Pressing enter gets us the table that shows us the number of observations, the mean, the standard deviation, as well as the smallest and largest value for each variable in the data set. Notice that the minimum value for at-bats in the data set is 500, which makes sense since that was my criteria for the baseball player showing up in the data set in the first place. The summary statistics also show us that the average number of home runs hit by these baseball players is a little over 19, with 3 home runs being the smallest number and 47 home runs hit by the home run leader in 2015, Chris Davis. We'll talk more about Chris on the first and second day of class. Stata's basic command for data transformation is generate, which creates a new variable with a name not currently in use. Let's create a new variable in our data set that calculates the baseball player's batting average in 2015. We need only specify the appropriate formula, and Stata will automatically apply it to every observation specified by the generate command, or GEN for short. We'll generate the variable for batting average, which I'll call AVG, by typing GEN AVG equals H for hits divided by AB for at-bats. Pressing enter generates the variable. Notice that AVG now shows up in the variables window on the right. Also, we can get the summary statistics for batting average by typing out SUM and pressing enter, and notice that AVG is listed at the bottom of the table. If we want the summary statistics for a particular variable, such as the newly created batting average variable, then we can simply type in SUM space AVG and press enter. And the table that gets generated is specifically for that particular variable. If you ever have trouble with the syntax for a particular command, you can always bring up Stata's help documentation for that command by typing in help and then the command. For example, I can enter help GEN and press enter to get detailed information about the properties of the generate command. Stata's help documentation might come in handy when we run regressions later in the semester. Let's get back to Stata's main window by closing the help viewer. For now, that's all we want to be able to do, so let's start wrapping up this tutorial by saving our data. To do this, let's click on the save icon on the toolbar. Notice that Stata wants to save the Excel spreadsheet that we imported as a Stata data or .dta file. We already have a MLB salaries 2015 Stata data file, so let's just overwrite that existing file. We can do that by clicking on that particular file that we want to overwrite, click save, and then click replace when Stata warns us that we would be overwriting the existing file. Finally, let's talk about the log file that we set up at the beginning of this video. Now that we are done, we can type log close in the command window and press enter. Stata now saves the log file in the location we specified earlier. In order to view a log file, we can click on the log icon on the toolbar, then click view, click on browse, and then select the Stata log file or the .smcl file that we would like to view, and then click open. Finally, clicking OK will open up the viewer with the log file. We can scroll down to see all of the Stata output that we had created during this tutorial. We'll learn more Stata commands and features as we progress through the course. By the end of the semester, you'll have learned how to run regressions and interpret the results so that you can call yourself a true econometrician.